Hi! In this video, we'll show you a new filter that helps create a visual echo effect. It's available in the free version of VSDC, and if you haven't had a chance to play with it yet, you're in for a treat. First things first, launch VSDC on your computer and drag your footage to the scene. The visual echo effect works best on videos that have a black or transparent background. That's why we're using this one. However, you can try it on any video you like. In the next step, we're going to split the video into two parts because we only want to apply the echo effect to the second part. Okay, good. So, unlike most video effects in VSDC, the echo filter works on the sprite level. So before applying it, you need to convert your video into a sprite. Either make a right mouse click on the video and select Convert to a Sprite, or use the Ctrl-P hotkey combination. When you're done, move to the Properties window on the right and find the following parameters. Use as container, switch to no. Show effects, switch to yes. Fill background, switch to no. Apply echo filter, select true. Here you go. This is what the default echo filter looks like. Now, there are three different blending modes available for the filter. They define the way frames blend in a video. In other words, they affect the way the echo effect looks. The default mode is called overlay, but if you switch to streak, you'll notice the difference. Another mode is called blur, and it creates a stronger effect than the overlay mode, but looks smoother than the streak mode, for example. If you want to learn more about the echo filter and understand how it works from a technical standpoint, head over to the link in the video description. We'd love to hear what you think about this filter, if you've tried it already, and if you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. Thank you for sticking around. Until next time.